So, good evening everyone.
Good evening.
So, you all are ready for taking the saree styling session?
Yes!
See, the fashion styling is integral part of pageant, okay? Though it is an individual thing, the styling, especially fashion styling, is very important. But when you go as an Indian, right? When you go internationally as an Indian, you should be fashionable, but you should stay back to your roots, right? So, you have to find that golden point where we are matching the two things, right? So you can be in a latest trends, but yet you are draping a very Indian piece of cloth called saree, right? So that is called a drapes. So we make sure that you are becoming stylish but staying Indian, and that magic is going to be we are going to train you on that fashion styling by our official fashion stylist. She is the managing director of AFTT, and she is a corporate designer for brands like Murugappa, Sarvana Stores. These are like very big brands here in Tamil Nadu. Not only here, everywhere there are big brands. So she is the one who designs clothes for them. So we are lucky to have her here. And teaches a very stylish saree. So last year one girl, she came, she learned this, and she entered in some corporate competition and she won the award. And she said, "See, thank you Aisha ma'am, I have won this for draping the saree in a very fashionable way." So most of the times we have a saree and we are wearing it once, and especially nowadays Facebook, you post it once and you cannot post it another time because it's one dress, right? The saree is a thing, you can drape it in so many forms and so many various styles. So one piece of cloth you can wear so many times with different drapes. So reuse, right? Go green, reuse. So she's going to teach you. So I would like to Aisha to just speak a little bit about her.
Firstly, I'd like to thank Deepali to have invited me here. It's a great privilege to be associated with Mrs. India again for the second consecutive year. And she is one person who empowers women. And take it from me, she really does it. And one person shouldering the entire pageant is something which I have not seen through my years of career. Okay, let me introduce myself first. I'm Mrs. Aisha, Managing Director, Academy of Fashion and Textile Technology, AFTT Design Studio, and Academy of Personality Development and Management. So basically, I'm a corporate designer. The Metro Rail's uniforms were designed by me. Shell Murugappa uniforms were designed by me. And I've designed many uniforms for corporate. I can't keep mentioning all that. And basically, I do retail designing for the Asia's biggest retail market. And my main concept is helping women. Wow. And that's the main reason why I have participated with Deepali. Empowering women is one thing which I really believe in doing. The main reason being, it's we who hold the house. Right? If we are strong,
yes.
The house is strong. Yes. If we are not, the house is strong. Yes. So basically,
I really like the drapes. It's a very important and very interesting part. So should we start now?
Yes. Before I start off, let me tell you what drapes are, because you should know what drapes are. Okay, drapes is basically an art. Okay. Here we go about with having the characteristics of a fabric come out in 3D formation. Okay, that's 3D dimension. What you have in your hand is just a fabric, but when you give form to it, it gives you a good appeal. It makes you more stylish and more elegant. It all depends upon the way you profile it on you. Okay, and this has not come out now. It's been there from the ancient period, from the Mesopotamian period, the Greek period. And here in India, we had the Pandyans, Dravidas. So all our drapes came through that. So basically, we are experimenting on a fabric which has no form and trying to give it a form of 3D dimension. That's what we are going to do. And basically, I'm to make things easy for you. Okay, I'm going to go about with teaching you certain techniques, okay, which I'll show you. Okay, you just follow it and it's no big deal. Keep your head cool, relax, you know your body form, right? You're going to help yourself because in the international pageants, you don't have anyone coming forward to helping you. You should be able to help yourself. Even when I'm going to go about with doing styling for you tomorrow, I'll be going about with helping you, okay, to look good front stage. I've been doing this for 27 years. This is my 20th year. So basically, here we start off with the fabric. Can I have a sari?
I really like the drapes. It's a very important and very interesting part. So should we start now?
Yes. Before I start off, let me tell you what drapes are, because you should know what drapes are. Okay, drapes is basically an art. Okay, here we go about with having the characteristics of a fabric come out in 3D formation. Okay, the 3D dimension. What you have in your hand is just a fabric, but when you give form to it, it gives you a good appeal. It makes you more stylish and more elegant. It all depends upon the way you profile it on you. Okay? And this has not come out now. It's been there from the ancient period, from the Mesopotamian period, the Greek period. And here in India, we had the Pandians, Dravidas. I hope you know them. So all our drapes came through that. So basically, we are experimenting on a fabric which has no form and trying to give it a form of 3D dimension. That's what we are going to do. And basically, I'm to make things easy for you. Okay, I'm going to go about with teaching you certain techniques. Okay, which I'll show you. Okay, you just follow it, and it's no big deal. Keep your head cool, relax, you know your body form, right? You're going to help yourself because in the international pageants, you don't have anyone coming forward to helping you. You should be able to help yourself. Even when I'm going to go about with doing styling for you tomorrow, I'll be going about with helping you, okay, to look good front stage. I've been doing this for 27 years now. This is my 20th year. Basically, here we start off with the fabric. Can I have a sari? Thank you. The first one is going to be a knot. I think many people know how to hold a sari.
Yes.
Right? You know how to wear a sari as well. Yeah, Indians,
yes.
Right?
Yes.
Now, you know how to go about a pleating.
Yes.
If you don't, anyone who doesn't know how to pleat a sari, yes, I see one there. No harm, you can tell me, I'll teach you. I'm here for that. Okay? This is your finger. Your index and your thumb, hold it like this. The thumb and your middle finger. The index finger
is good.
Go about with maintaining a dimension.
Can you repeat that one so that we'll take a close up of that bit?
Yes. Okay.
I'm so sorry.
No, it's okay. No problem. You want any repeat? You can tell me. All for you, Deepali. Don't worry. Okay. This is going to be your index finger. And this is going to be your index finger and your thumb. Okay, go about with holding your sari with the middle finger at the edge and the thumb on the other side. The index finger is going to be rooted down to how many inches you want. I'm just going to go about with taking 2 inches. Now, how do you measure these 2 inches? If you know well, we have something called a scale, which is this index finger measures to 1 inch. Many people don't know this, but we as designers, and this is what I teach my students, because we don't go about with using a scale at all. We do freehand illustrations. So you got to know what the measures are. So this is your 1 inch and this is your 2 inches. Hold it. The thumb and the index finger goes right there, the index finger, fold. So you go about with making folds like this. You would have made fan folds in paper?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
When you're small?
Yes.
It's the same thing. No big deal. You have the fold here?
Yes.
This is going to be your hand, your palm. Have it wide. You don't have to practice now. Look at me. I'm there for you, so don't get tense. So the time I told you, you have to do it by yourself, I'll start practicing. just look at me. This is your hand, your palm. Hold it. Take it down the stream. Leave some area here on 10 inches. And go about with holding, pushing it down to another 10 inches. Did you see what I did? Stream it down to 10 inches. Push it down to 10 inches. That means I had taken the right hand, pushed it to the right and my left. Fold and go about with making a knot. This is going to be your first technique. Can you see?
Yes.
It creates a fan fold. And the knot should not be any knot. It has to be a proper macrame. Have you heard about a macrame?
Mm-hmm.
People who are in NCC, NSS? No? Okay. This knot figures down to X. Because when you wear it, it should look good. It's just not that you bundle it up like a dhobi bundle.
Like a tie. Yeah. Like
yes. This is almost equivalent to that.
Yeah.
Okay. And then this is one technique. You want me to repeat the technique? I'll just show it to you. From the knot, stream it down to another 10 inches. This distance is very much required. The main reason is, in case you want to emphasize on what you're doing,
mm-hmm.
the distance plays a very important role. Okay? Push it down to another 10 inches. Roll it. Your two fingers, the three fingers, put it forward. You can see my middle finger is out. The other two fingers are in. Bring it down. Put your four fingers inside. And go about with having it knotted. Once I knot it, I don't pull it immediately. I have to stream it back to the 10 inches what I have left. So this is again a X. So this is one type. Okay? The next thing is your cowl. When I am talking about a cowl,